Hello everyone, and welcome to Hill Street. Today's story is Less Than 24 Hours by Skittish Reflections. If you end up enjoying this story, please leave a like. And if you enjoy hearing stories from me, please subscribe and become a resident of Hill Street. And let me know how I'm doing in the comments. Now, let's get to this nightmare. I didn't think anything of it at first. It was just a random design graffitied across the window of the local deli. The same deli burned down the next morning. Electrical fire, they said. Thankfully, no one got hurt. A month later, on one of my hikes, I noticed an odd shape formed by the grooves on one of our oldest trees. A circle cut in half vertically, with a diagonal line across it from the upper right to the lower left. I didn't remember seeing it there before, and it reminded me a lot of the deli's graffiti. Less than 24 hours later, lightning struck that tree, killing it. It was a strange coincidence, but I didn't take it seriously until the next day. My neighbor publicly shaming his son for ruining their family car. We gathered around to see the damage. The bumper had a scratch, and it bore a strong resemblance of that same design. That evening, the car was totaled when the son forgot to put it in park when he got out. It rolled into the path of a truck. That was when I began paying attention. Hoping to confirm my suspicions, I went to a building that was set for demolition a day before. I noticed a few bricks on the back wall were lighter than the rest. They weren't like that before, and their rough shape formed that same symbol. The next morning, the demolition occurred as scheduled, and my suspicions were confirmed. That symbol was the mark of destruction, of death. I now began keeping an eye out for it. My curiosity piqued. I scrutinized structures, both natural and man-made, but it was my elderly neighbor's dog that was next on the list. While I was dropping off her groceries, her white Maltese ran up to greet me, and the green stains on his damp fur drew my attention. The symbol. I asked the owner if I could see it, and she laughed and said he'd rolled in freshly mowed grass earlier that morning, and that she couldn't wash all the green out. I pointed out the symbol, and she found it interesting, but not worrying. I was worried though, and I told her to take him in for a checkup right away. Concerned, she did. They told her he was healthy for an old dog, yet he still passed away in his sleep that evening. I consoled her when she called with the sad news, but my thoughts were buzzing with morbid curiosity. The symbol seemed to appear a maximum of 24 hours before death. Would I be able to know who died within a day? Would food have the same symbol before they were to be eaten? Did others know about this sinister omen? As I got ready for bed that night, I realized I'd overlooked a text message from an unknown number. Curious, I opened it. It was spam. Rolling my eyes, I went to delete it, only to notice two shapes side by side within the foreign text. An O with a forward dash through it, and a O with a line vertically through it. Alone, they meant nothing to me, but if they were to be overlapped, they looked eerily like the symbol. That symbol, the harbinger of doom. My blood ran cold. I was going to die. I stood, frozen, too afraid to move as my heart rioted in my chest. Was I going to get a heart attack in my sleep? Or slip in the shower tomorrow morning and crack my skull? Or choke on my breakfast and suffocate? Or die in an accident while delivering groceries? Or get stabbed after someone mugged me? The possibilities were endless, and that terrified me even more. I wasn't ready to die, and wasn't going to give in. I just had to make sure I survived these next 24 hours. I didn't want to lose the delivery job I landed only a week ago, but I didn't want to risk any accidents. I had no choice but to take a sick day. Tomorrow morning, if I survived that long, I'd call my boss. If she fired me, that would be another blow to my job-hopping reputation, but at least I'd be alive. Trembling, I carefully unplugged everything in my apartment and turned off all the lights, hoping to avoid any possibility of an electrical fire. Afterwards, I sat on my couch, determined to move as little as possible. I wasn't going to sleep, though. Many people died in their sleep. I wasn't going to eat or go to the bathroom either. I also didn't want to use any electronics, not even my phone. I'd heard how those can explode randomly. The seconds ticked, and I remained sitting, sweat trickling down my back as every sound and shadow made me jump. A car passed by, its headlights skimming across my apartment wall. Did it just illuminate a fleeting glimpse of the symbol on my mirror? Was it going to fall on me? Gulping, I crawled to the center of the room, the furthest from any walls and furniture. The floorboards creaked, and my heart rattled as I wondered if a deadly spider would crawl out and be my undoing. I stood up, wiping the sweat off my upper lip as I looked around in distress. Where would be the safest place to hide from death? A dark shape in the corner of the room caught my eye, and ice filled my veins as I stared at it, my rabid heart thrashing against my ribs. Did someone break in? I took a terrified step back, my breath stuttering, and I sank to the floor in tearful relief when another car passed by, illuminating my coat hanging on the door, exactly where I always left it. My nerves were driving me insane. Maybe this was how I died, scared to death by the horrifying scenarios my frantic mind came up with. I needed to calm down, but I needed to remain vigilant. I needed to be logical, but I needed to be ready for anything. I also needed the bathroom. Although I was mentally prepared to wet myself, I wasn't willing to empty my bowels and my pants. And this was the latter. I could do this. I just had to be extra careful. Should I turn on the lights? That could help me avoid possible mishaps. But what if an electrical fire was what killed me? I shouldn't risk it. I knew the layout of my apartment well enough. With a nervous gulp, I looked at my phone. Perhaps I should take it with me. If anything happened, at least I could call for help. After grabbing my phone, I crawled down the hall, each step slow and deliberate. Once I reached the bathroom, the idea of sewer snakes crawling out of the toilet made me pause in dread. It sounded insane, but it could happen. My pulse thumping, I turned on my phone's flashlight and peered in the bowl, just to be sure. The shaky beam glided over the water. and I gasped as I lost my grip. My phone fell into the toilet with a plop. After a second of stunned silence, I erupted in hysterical laughter, sobbing between each breath as I collapsed on the floor. Of course, it was my phone. The symbol was on my phone. Why did I think it was me? I was such an idiot. Relief never felt as warm as it did that night, and I slept like I never slept before. The next morning, I felt as though I'd been given a new lease on life. After digging out my old crack phone, I drove to work with a smile, glad I didn't risk getting fired by taking a sick day, only a week into my new job. After carrying stuffed paper bags to my trunk, the banana sticking out had me take a curious pause, hoping I wouldn't get scolded for rummaging through a customer's groceries. I leaned over, studying each banana. There it was, the symbol on one of the fruits, barely perceptible. This banana was going to be eaten within the next 24 hours. Excited, I went to check the remaining groceries, but a cold touch on the back of my neck made me gasp and recoil. I turned in alarm, only to find myself facing my startled girlfriend. "Oh my God, I'm sorry, babe. I didn't mean to scare you," she said, after laughing as she covered her mouth. "Chantal, your hands are like ice," I said, rubbing the back of my neck with a shudder. She giggled. "I know. I was just checking out your new work. When did you get it?"
"A week ago," I replied, slamming the trunk.
"When'd you get back?"
"Yesterday." She wrapped her arms around me as we shared a kiss. "I missed you the entire time."
"I missed you too. There's so much I want to tell you."
"There's so much I want to do to you," she whispered, giving my ear a nibble.
"You free tonight?"
My blood rushed.
"Yes."
"Hey!"
My boss clapped her hands to get my attention. "I'm not paying you to make out. Save that for after work and get those groceries delivered."
"Right away,"
I said, as Chantal and I untangled ourselves. "Sorry, Tal, but I better deliver these now, or I could lose this job too."
"I won't keep you," she said. "We'll pick up where we left off tonight. Should I drop by at 7?
"Perfect." She blew me a kiss before she walked into the store, and I whistled as I did my deliveries, smiling at the thought of tonight. On my way home, I passed by my favorite pizza place for a large double cheese. I couldn't help but check it when I got home. The symbol wasn't visible on any slice, and I wondered if it would be hidden beneath the cheese. I couldn't wait to tell Chantal so we could find it together. The moment I opened the door after her knock, she pounced on me with a kiss, and I hugged her as we stumbled back into my apartment, laughing. We fell on the couch, and my hands began to roam, but she stopped me and stood up with a grin.
Wait, I want to show you something," she said, unraveling her scarf.
I leaned back with an eager smile.
"Oh, a striptease?"
"That's part of it," she said with a wink as she pulled her sweater off. She twirled it over her head, and I chuckled as she flung it at my face. With a playful smile, she turned her back to me, swaying her hips as she lifted her hair up, and my heart dropped. The symbol, freshly tattooed on the nape of her neck. She glanced over her shoulder as she let her hair tumble back down, and her smile turned to an open-mouthed shock
when I ran up to her in a panic. Grabbing her hair, I yanked her up and pushed her head down, my mouth dry as I stared at the symbol with disbelief. "How'd you get this?" I yelled, my voice shaking with fear and despair. "Ow, babe, you're hurting me. How'd you get this?" "I had it done after work." "Why? Why? Why are you so upset?" she asked, on the verge of tears. "I just wanted to surprise you." "Why'd you get this symbol?"
"I liked yours this morning and thought it would be cool to get a matching tattoo."